Right, Australian cricket scene has indeed changed a lot in the last 10 to 15 years. We didn't see too many ethnic stars in the Australian cricket team. Although the other sporting codes in Australia, like the rugby league, rugby union, or AFL or soccer, embraced the ethnic communities wholeheartedly, Australian cricket team didn't have too many ethnic stars till recently. Although we saw some of them, like Andrew Simons or Simon Cattich and others, who played proudly for Australia. Now let's take a look at that interview I did with the emerging ethnic star Arjun Nair. Arjun, welcome to the program.
Thank you for having me.
Now, of course, you are very young, and we are very glad to see you representing Australia at this age. How this all started, this passion for you?
I think my dad started his passion for me. I was like 4 years old, and in the backyard he started throwing balls at me, so I think I gained interest from there.
Did it start at the school level for you?
Yes, I think career got more serious around year 10 stage when I started making the under 17 New South Wales team. That's when I realised, okay, this can be something I can do in the future. So I've always liked playing the game. So for me, I thought I just keep working hard and see where I go.
And once you came to the grade level, which club did you play for?
Hawkesbury, my old batting coach Bill Madden, he used to be one of the coaches there, so I played Green Shield there, so I ended up playing my grade cricket there as well.
So which, that's the first grade?
Yeah, first grade, yeah.
How did you go in your grade cricket?
Grade cricket I found a bit tough. I debuted when I was 15 years old, so I was very young, so it took me a bit of time to get used to playing men's cricket. So, but now I'm starting to enjoy it more. I've learned a lot through playing those tough cricket.
Who in Hawkesbury helped you out with coaching and professional level tips?
As I said, when I was younger, Bill Mann, he's my old batting coach. He helped me a lot with my batting. So he brought me to Hawkesbury, and it's a very good club for me to grow and learn a lot of stuff. So right now, the first grade captain, Jay Dyball, is very good help. We have a new coach, Neil DaCosta. They've been very helpful this season.
And when did you think that you belong to the big boys club? You are going to go over and play for Australia.
I've always had a self-belief. I think that's very important for every player, to have the self-belief within themselves about their ability. So for me, that never lacked. So it's about just being confident and express my skills. That's the key.
Right. So when were you picked to play for under 19, wasn't
yeah.
it, for Australia?
I think it was in year 12. I was almost 1.5 years ago. I got the call to go play in England, against England, for Australia under-19s, and that was a big step for me. That was a big step, so I ended up doing pretty decently well there, which helped me gain confidence for the future as well.
Would you call yourself a bowling all-rounder or a batting all-rounder?
I think that varies. It depends which one I do well in that game. I try to work on both as equally hard, and whatever helps me get into various teams, that's what I'll focus on.
Yes. Well, off-spin. Is something which is an art which, there are a lot of competitors. What's your speciality in bowling off-spin?
I think my variety is a bit different. I'm not traditional, like the traditional off-spinner. I have a carom ball. My off-spin is a bit different compared to usual. So for me, I'm trying to get my uniqueness and making it effective on the pitch. That's what I try to do.
Well, you're seeing a lot of off-spinners bowl, including Nathan Lyon, who bowls for Australia, and also Graham Swan for England, and Ravichandran Ashwin for India. Who do you think you have modelled yourself for?
There's an IPL game I watched a few years ago, and I saw Sunil Narayan bowl. That was the first time I saw him bowl, and he took 5 wickets again, and that just struck. I was like, oh, who's this guy? So I went back on YouTube and had a look at his videos, and I started working on the back of my dad. And my dad couldn't really find it hard to play, so I went to a coach called Anthony Clark. He helped me a lot with my bowling. And from then on, it's been good so far, yeah.
Talking about Sunil Narayan, of course, he is also playing in the BBL,
yeah.
Big Bash League. And when did you get the call to play for Sydney Thunder? You are wearing Sydney Thunder jersey.
Yeah, so I was a rookie last season. So I was with the team and training with them. This year, I got the actual full contract with part of the actual squad. So for me, it's a good experience. But my main goal is to play as many games as possible and perform well. That's my goal.
Yeah, some of the superstars of cricket like Shane Watson, Owen Morgan. How is it to play with alongside those guys?
Yeah, it's good. Some of the guys I've been watching on TV when I was younger. So, but they're great guys. They help you a lot, encourage you a lot. So, for me, it was quite easy to get in and feel good about the squad. So, yeah, it's been good so far. Mm.
And of course, we all know that Mark Wai is your governor of Sydney Thunder. Does he give you any tips on from his experience?
He's not there much. He's a bit busy with commentary and stuff. So, we don't see him too often. But I think the players and coaches we have within the Thunder setup is very good. So, I think we keep playing as we've done the last couple of games. We should hopefully just sneak into the semi-finals.
Yes. Good luck with that. And the other thing is, of course, what does the future hold for Arjun Nair?
Future, I think for me, it's getting more opportunities and performing well when I get the opportunities. So hopefully can play more Shield games and a couple more games left in the Big Bash. So hopefully I can get the opportunity to perform well. That's the key, is performing well and putting your name up there. So it's all about staying patient and working hard for me.
Every young man's dream is to wear the baggy green and play for Australia. What about you?
Same for me. I want to play all three formats. That's the main goal. So stuff like Big Bash is a very big stepping stone for me to obviously show myself, my skills. And obviously Sheffield Shield is a very big step as well. I think that's one step below the baggy green. So if I perform well there, gives me a good chance.
That was Arjun Nair, who has the dream of wearing the baggy green. Good luck to Arjun.